for the week of June 13th, 2011. This is the Yokosuka Report on Channel 15, your place for news on the fleet, service members, and our community.
Sailors from various commands at Fleet Activities Yokosuka came together for a base run and a ceremony to commemorate the Battle of Midway. Lieutenant Commander Jed Espiritu, who was the guest speaker at the ceremony, said Midway was a crucial victory for the Allies in World War II.
Today was a wonderful day. We commemorated the Battle of Midway and our role as a Navy in World War II, and how the Battle of Midway was a pivotal point in the World War, not only for the Pacific Theater, but in the grand strategy of the Allies.
This year also marks 100 years of naval aviation, and the Battle of Midway was an important landmark in that history. Senior Chief Anthony Patton said knowing what past sailors have given and achieved compels him to serve in the present Navy.
It was a great milestone in naval aviation. Me being an ABF, former carrier sailor, I've served on 4 aircraft carriers, and so, you know, seeing what our forefathers did gives me the drive to continue to want to do more with the Navy today. If you don't know where you came from, you're not going to really know where you're going.
The Battle of Midway occurred between June 4th and 7th, 1942, approximately 6 months after the attack on Pearl Harbor. Petty Officer Bryan, Reckard, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
Kinnick High School at Fleet Activities Yokosuka opened the Life After Kinnick Resource Room, a one-stop resource center for students to plan their career choices after high school. Lakara Silver, a senior at Kinnick High School, explains.
What we have here tonight is the Life After Kinnick Resource Center, and basically it's a center used for high school students. And for those who want to find more about their career, or if they're not going to college, they may look for something that would interest them in the near future.
The Resource Center brings information about colleges, military, and technical career choices together in a central location.
The need for students to have a special place to plan for life after high school came from our continuous school improvement efforts here. Teachers plan for what we can do to help students improve, and that would mean improving their academic achievement and beyond.
The community gave an enthusiastic response to the new Resource Center, as Silver describes.
It's so cool to see how the books are laid out on the table and get to see the college posters and everything. And I think that's great because a lot of students would need that in order to succeed, you know, to be able to get more information out of their colleges that they would like, as well as seeing what career path fits them.
Petty Officer Chris Henry, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
Members of USS Curtis Wilbur's Wardroom visit USS Steedham in dry dock for a better understanding of ship maneuvering and navigation capabilities.
Curtis Wilbur's Wardroom is providing some in-depth junior officer training prior to deployment for non-qualified surface warfare officers. We decided to take advantage of the USS Steedham being in dry dock and come see a different perspective of the ship.
Being able to familiarize themselves with the structure and placement of equipment, which is normally underwater, gives these sailors a better understanding on how to control the ship when steering and performing at-sea maneuvers.
As surface warfare officers, there's many different aspects, different considerations that you have to consider when you're driving the ship. Additionally, you're required to get a lot of qualifications. You learn a lot about the engineering equipment and a lot of the discharges overside. Seeing those actually on the ship below the waterline also helps give you a good visual on actually how a lot of equipment works, functions, and where it's located throughout the ship.
Due to dry docking availabilities, this type of in-depth training is rare and is not always available for sailors to attend.
The ship won't be in dry dock for quite some time, so this is kind of a once-in-a-lifetime experience for a lot of people.
Petty Officer Michael Story, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.